I would like to leave this city. This old town don't smell too pretty, and I can feel the warning signs running around my mind. And when I leave this island, I book myself into a soul asylum. 'Cause I can feel the warning signs running around my mind. So here I go, still scratching around in the same old hole. My body feels young, but my mind is very old. So what do you say? You can't give me the dreams that are mine anyway. Half the world away. Half the world away.
If you grew up in the 80s or 90s, you've probably heard of Contra. It's a game that's notorious for being so difficult that it requires a cheat code to beat.
Ask anyone between the ages of 25 and 35, and there's a good chance they'll be able to tell you the Contra 30 guy code from memory.
Contra was released in arcades in 1987, but it's set in the year 2633. It features two guerrilla soldiers named Bill and Lance, whose mission is to defend the Earth from the evil Red Falcon organization, who are bent on taking over the world.
Just who the Red Falcon organization are and why they want to take over the world is unclear. Their plot seems to consist of a bunch of aliens or something. It doesn't matter.
But don't say it doesn't matter. Every line matters.
Anyway, instead of the usual palette-swapped red guy and blue guy, these dudes look like Arnold Schwarzenegger and Rambo with red and blue headbands.
You start with a standard gun that fires comically large white bullets, but you can score a variety of different guns, like the spread gun, which, as the name implies, fires a large spread of bullets.
One gun you don't want to pick up is the laser gun, which only fires a short laser stream aimed at whatever's directly in front of you. Ugh, it sucks.
What makes Contra stand out from other shoot-em-ups is the fact that you can fire in all different directions, even diagonally, and you can fire while running and jumping.
This comes in handy while you're defending yourself from the barrage of bullets being fired at you from all directions.
It doesn't help that there's no life bar. So if you get hit once, you die.
You die, you die, you die, you die. You die. Oh, you die.
And once you use up all your lives, you can't just put in another quarter and continue where you left off. You have to start the level all over again.
In a two-player game, the player who uses up their lives first has to wait for the other player to burn all of their lives before continuing.
Oh, I'm dead. Man, I can't continue. Hurry up and die.
Ooh, that was close. Man, I'm really good at this game. Oh, man, I killed the boss. Didn't lose a life at all. Oh, I'm really good at this next level, too.
Man.
Another thing that makes Contra unique is all of the platforming involved. There are vertical levels where you have to keep jumping up higher and higher.
In a two-player game, if a player lags behind, they can get murdered by the screen.
It also has a pseudo 3D level, where the screen advances as you run forward. It looks primitive now, but at the time, it was revolutionary.
The 3D part of this game. Oh! Look at that. Future is here.
Yeah.
Future video game is right there.
The 3D level appears to let you set your own path by selecting a left or right arrow. However, you can only go in one direction. If you try to go the other way, you'll be blocked.
The most confusing thing about this game is that it gives you a finite number of continues. Once you use them up, that's it. Game over. It doesn't matter how many quarters you put in, you're done.
It's like it was designed to not make any money. Didn't Konami want to encourage people to add quarters so that they could keep continuing? Instead, the game just ends.
Fortunately, there are nerds on YouTube with more time on their hands than us, so we can see the ending.
Everything disappears, and then the credits scroll with little 8-bit images of the programmers' faces. Aww.
NES Contra is the version that everyone is familiar with. It was released in 1988 and included the same innovative gameplay featured in the arcade version.
The cover features an artist's rendition of Arnold Schwarzenegger in Predator. It looks exactly like him, except with a headband.
One big new feature of NES Contra is the now famous code. Use the code to get yourself 30 lives, and the game is actually playable, even for casual gamers.
The only problem is, you have to enter the code very quickly at the start screen, so it can be difficult for people with big hands like me to get it right.
You fat-handed twat.
Oh man! Alright, hold on, I can do it. Alright, that time for sure. It's definitely gonna work that time. Got 3 lives! Okay, let's start. That time only selected 1 player. And 3 lives! Ah! Alright, one more time. I swear to God I can get it this time, I swear. Up, up, down, down, left, right, B, A, B, A, select, start. Oh my God!
Other differences are that the 3D level no longer has the pointless arrows that pretend to let you pick a direction, and the story is quite a bit different.
According to the instruction manual, Red Falcon is now a life form that first crashed on the Earth in 1957. 30 years later, this hideous being is terrifying Earthlings with his army of alien henchmen.
Apparently, the government doesn't want to upset current political stability, so instead of an all-out assault, they've opted to send only 2 Special Forces commandos, Bill and Lance, who now go by the codenames of Mad Dog and Scorpion, and the fate of the entire universe rests on their burly shoulders.
Yes, while Red Falcon the organization wanted to take over the Earth, Red Falcon the life form apparently wants to destroy the whole universe. That seems a little extreme, don't you think?
The story concludes with, if you fail, life as we know it will cease to exist, and vile Red Falcon will rule forever. If you succeed, well, it doesn't matter, because I doubt you will. That's right. The game actually doubts our ability to beat it. Thanks for the vote of confidence.
And now it's time for a love-hate review.
Ah, Contra. I have so many memories of playing this game as a kid. And I hate it!
I love it. The fast pace, the sharp controls, and being able to shoot in almost every direction.
I hate that I have to jump up in order to shoot down, because if I just hit down on the D-pad, I jump down to a lower level and get killed.
I love the 2-player co-op action that lets us share lives, so if you die first, you can take one of mine.
I hate that one hit kills me. I die every 2 seconds, and if I don't keep up with you, the screen kills me.
I love the challenge of the game, and that 30 guy code makes it easier to master.
I hate that the difficulty isn't progressive. It starts out really hard, and it stays really hard. I shouldn't need a cheat code just to get past the first level.
I love all the different kinds of guns you can use, like the spread gun and the machine gun.
I hate that useless laser gun. I can only shoot an enemy if he's standing right in front of me, and by that time I'm already dead. And I hate that I lose my gun when I die. I die so often I may as well not even pick one up. And why couldn't the stock gun at least have turbo?
I love the different types of levels, like the vertical platforming levels and those cool 3D levels. I mean, look, it's 3D!
I hate all the platforming. I can't concentrate on jumping while I'm also trying to avoid a million bullets being fired at me at once. And did I mention the screen deaths? The 3D level's even worse. The perspective is way off, and it's hard to see where I'm shooting.
I love the detailed graphics, especially all those creepy alien bosses.
I hate all those damn Konami environmental hazards. It's bad enough I'm facing creepy aliens in a hail of gunfire, but now I also have to avoid getting zapped by lasers and impaled on spikes? Come on!
This has been a love-hate review.
The game's notorious difficulty makes the ending even more satisfying.
First, there's a scene of a helicopter flying away from an island, just like in Jurassic Park.
Congratulations, you've destroyed the vile Red Falcon and saved the universe. Consider yourself a hero. If that isn't an ego boost, I don't know what is.
And the music is awesome.
Then for some reason, the game starts over again, and it doesn't even restore your lives. Really?
We just played it, man. Why would we do it again?
Also in 1988, a sequel to Contra called Super Contra was released in arcades. No relation to the Super Nintendo, which didn't come out until 1991.
This one features a cool intro that starts with 1 year after the battle. Where have we seen that before?
1 year after the battle. The city that had once been plagued with crime and violence was safe and peaceful.
The quest for freedom continues.
What is this place? Keep your eyes peeled.
Graphics in Super Contra are more detailed than in regular Contra, but the gameplay is basically the same. Instead of the 3D level, there are now overhead levels where you can throw bombs as well as shoot.
The overhead levels are a little confusing at first, because the walls tend to look like different parts of the floor.
Super Contra actually feels a little easier than the original, with less bullets flying at you from all over the place.
Unfortunately, you get zero continues, so once you're dead, that's it. Game over.
Okay, so I guess this game doesn't want my quarters at all. That's fine. I'll keep them for when I need to use a payphone. Let's go to YouTube and check out the ending.
You are the best Contra. All right!
In 1990, Super Contra was released on the NES, but the title was changed to Super C, possibly because of the Iran-Contra affair, which led to the indictments of National Security Council member Oliver North and National Security Advisor John Poindexter in 1988.
Fun fact! The Iran-Contra affair was a political scandal that occurred during the second term of the Reagan administration, in which senior administration officials facilitated the sale of arms to Iran in order to secure the release of several U.S. hostages and fund the Contras, a group of rebel organizations who opposed the Sandinista Junta of National Reconstruction Government in Nicaragua.
Sorry, that's not a fun fact. That's a disappointing fact.
The NES version is very true to the arcade version in terms of gameplay, but now you actually have some continues. However, like an arcade Contra, both players have to continue at the same time. So once again, Jen has to wait around for me to die.
Oh man, I'm dead again. Oh. Can you just die already so I can continue?
Oh, spread gun, yeah!
Wait.
Can't get it! Got spread gun. Got spread gun.
I wanna play.
Well, don't die then. I mean, just like be good. It's like it's easy. It's an easy game.
I'm supposed to be good if I can't continue.
It's not Contra. Yeah! Woo!
There is no 30 guy code for Super C on the NES, but there is a code that gives you 10 lives. I guess that's better than nothing.
The game uses a lot of diagonals, which make it difficult to shoot enemies at the right angle.
It's like the programmers just figured out how to make diagonal lines, and they were so proud that they used them everywhere.
They're diagonal.
The alien bosses are even creepier than they were in original Contra, like this one that throws skulls at us, which then crawl around on the ground using their gaping mouths. Cool.
Instead of being a little easier like arcade Super Contra, This game kicks your ass. Everywhere you turn, you're being pelted with deadly bubbles. Yeah, that's right. Your worst enemies in this game are bubbles. Not the terrifying alien creatures, bubbles.
At the end, you fight a massive alien with a human face, then watch a helicopter fly off into the sunset to some more awesome music.
There were tons of other Contra sequels released on everything from the Game Boy to the ZX Spectrum, but Contra and Super Contra are two classics that we'll always remember along with the famous code.
It's an older code, sir, but it checks out.
Nintendo Power will save the day and give us a chance so we can beat this game. Up, up, down, down, left, right, B-A, select and start. To get some 30 guys and your chance to win. It's a shame I gotta cheat, but I gotta live.